This was one of those ones that I read and was just like, oh, I would do anything in this. I would literally be a shrub. Like, because it doesn't, and you can't really put your finger on it immediately. It's just something about, to me, I think it was the way the story was told and the writing is just, was just stunning. And I talked to a few people who had also read it, and everybody had just sort of said, that really stayed with me. It's kind of the main character. I mean, I think there's a lifestyle that comes along with living in a place that's this harsh and in a way desolate. And I think it's isolating. And I think it makes your communities even, you know, more important, because the few people around you, that's really what you've got. And you have to sort of, you come together to get through nature, to deal with nature. And so I think that's why with Wind River, the community is so broken, and it makes it that much more tragic. The pacing is so interesting because it's steady and kind of creepy. It's like creeps along, but it never feels slow. And then all of a sudden, it's just like, you know.
From what I do know, is they come across a murder situation. Their job is to look after the local affairs on the reserve, but if they come across a murder, the FBI has to be called in on it. And the state police have no jurisdiction on the reserve, and they have no jurisdiction off the reserve. So the FBI have to intervene on that. And the Bureau of Indian Affairs and all kinds of people get involved in it, and I'm surprised things don't get more messed up than they are by people trying to come in and grab the glory. And sometimes evidence gets missed and destroyed, and the wrong people get blamed, and that's how it works. But the tribal police are just there, more or less, to supervise. Jeremy Renner plays a character called Corey, and he works for the Fish and Wildlife. And his job is to keep down predators and pests like that. He's a hunter. He's been a hunter all his life. He doesn't work for me, but we're friends. We work a lot together on certain things, and we know one another. I've known him for years. Let's say that Ben has known Corey for years, and they're probably working one another. This is their office. This is where they work, you know. It's just like humdrum to him. Ben is he's a sort of a cynical guy, but he's fair, crusty but benign, and he doesn't like people interfering from the outside so much. But he has no choice but to call in the FBI, because that's the way the book is written, or the Bureau of Indian Affairs. He doesn't like those guys coming around here snooping around, bothering people. He's got his end under control. He knows what's going on. You know, if he wants to stop that, he can get intervention if he wants, but he just goes and talks to the people and says, look, don't do that.
Hey, Vale here with an added bonus to this video. Now, just like me, I'm sure you love movies, and I've got some pretty interesting movie budget facts, if I do say so myself. Did you know that the movie Gravity was more expensive than the Indian Mars mission? Yes. Paranormal Activity cost less than $15,000 to make, but crossed over $193 million. The production of Disney's film Tangled was more expensive than Avatar's production. Best Picture Oscar winner Moonlight was made for only $1.5 million. There hasn't been a Best Picture winner with a budget that low since Rocky. Napoleon Dynamite had a budget of only $400,000, and John Heder was paid only $1,000 for his role as Napoleon. Pirates of the Caribbean on Stranger Tides officially holds the record for the most expensive movie ever made, with a budget of $378.5 million. Okay, so if you want to watch more videos like this, hit the subscribe button and ring the notification bell so you receive the videos the moment they are online. Bye-bye!